We've all been there before. You have an idea for a scene, but you have no idea how to light it. Today, I'll be walking through three lighting setups that you can use in your next project. They'll be simple compared to some larger budget setups. First up, a bathroom mirror, then a dinner table, and finally, in a car. They're all pretty common locations that you might find yourself needing to build a scene around, so I thought this could be pretty helpful. The setups have tight spaces, and some will require the use of a boom arm, so I'll need a light that is soft, compact, and lightweight. I'll be using the Suray A100B. This is a bi-color LED fixture. To set it up, I'll first connect the adapter, which attaches right on using magnets and clips. I'll put the light on a boom arm, plug it in, and now the light automatically inflates. Once the inflating is complete, you can now see the built-in diffusion. The entire light fixture is only about 4 inches thick. This will work great for the setups today. The first shot is in front of a bathroom mirror. I feel like these shots are commonly used in films and commercials. Here's an example from La La Land, which was shot by Linus Sandgren. The light source is coming from above the mirror and hitting the subject's face, giving a top lighting look. Although with this example, the light is a bit more to the side, allowing for some shadows here. The key light that is on the subject's face, as you can see in the mirror, is also acting as the backlight on the subject. There are other lights for fill and color in this shot, but our focus is only on the key light. In another example, this time from Jolt, as shot by Jules O'Loughlin, you can see the main source of light is above the mirror hitting the subject's face. You might be led to believe that these two lights here are what is lighting the subject, but there's another source out of frame motivating the light from the two practical fixtures. The top-down lighting in front of the mirror is what we'll be trying to replicate today. Let's place this subject in front of the mirror. In order to get the light above the frame, I'll be using a boom arm. With heavy fixtures, you'll need to use a menace arm, which requires more space and heavier equipment. Because the light I'm using weighs less than 4 pounds, a boom arm will work great. I'll take a C-stand, remove the arm, and add the boom. I'll attach the light and adjust the angle using the ball head. Next, I'll throw a sandbag on the end of the boom and extend the arm to balance everything out, and raise the light where I need it to go. I want a warm look, so I'll set the light to 3200 Kelvin and 7% intensity. And my camera's white balance to 3700 Kelvin. Because I'm going for a moodier look, I'll add a grid to the A100B. This prevents light spilling onto the walls. Of course, you could use a tube light for something like this, but a larger source will allow for softer light on the subject's skin. Here are my camera settings, and here's what the final shot looks like. Now we're moving to the dinner table. Dinner table scenes are always used. It's a great opportunity for characters to have conversation. For an example from the movies, here's another shot from La La Land. At this dinner scene, the four subjects are seated at the table. The soft light is facing down from above. It's convenient because it's lighting each subject, allowing for multiple angles and minimal lighting changes. The light is boomed over the table and diffused. Let's set this up ourselves. The subject will be sitting right in the center of the table. Now, just like the bathroom mirror shot, I'll boom the light over the subject. It's important to put the light over the table rather than directly over the subject's head. You want the light to feel natural for whoever's watching. I have no grid here because I want the light to spill onto the background a bit in order to match the wide shot that you'll see in about 30 seconds. The light is set to 2800 Kelvin at 1%. To add a bit more contrast, I'll take another light outside and direct it through the window. It's set to 6500 Kelvin at 13%. Here are my camera settings. A question you might have is, how do you shoot an extra wide shot for this scene? I would remove the A100B and shoot it with the practical fixture, especially if you want to see the ceiling. And then when you move in for the medium shot, you can bring in the boom for the soft light. The practical fixture has bulbs that are 2700 Kelvin, so that's why I chose to use the warmest color temperature on the A100B. This way, I didn't have to mess with my camera's white balance for each shot. Let's check out the final shot. Now before we move on to the car shot, I wanted to briefly explain the boom arm. Your lighting fixture goes on the baby pin. This hook on the other end is here so that you can balance everything out with a sandbag or shot bag. To see if it's balanced, loosen this knuckle. If the light or weight doesn't fall down, you're good to go. If not, extend or shorten the arm or add more weight to either of the sides. Once it's balanced, lock it down. Car scenes, especially during the day, can be extremely difficult to film if you don't have a large budget.
The best looking and safest way to pull this off is by using a process trailer. You can rig camera and lighting outside of the subject's car on the trailer, all while the subject can focus on their acting because they aren't actually doing the driving. Take this setup from Baby Driver, DP'd by Bill Pope. This is an example of a process trailer, although this was a pretty unique setup that they made for this film. You can see the lighting and camera placement around the base of the trailer. This is safe and effective,
but this is too expensive.
For a cheaper option, you could film in a studio or garage with a green screen, but it just doesn't look as realistic as filming outside. I decided to go another route. The issue with filming in a car during the day is that when you're filming a subject inside of a car, it's impossible to expose them correctly without blowing out the sky.
In order to hold the highlights of the sky and properly expose the skin, we need to add light to the subject. With no budget, this can be tricky to pull off.
There are so many variables that you'll have to work through. My goal for this setup was to have a moving vehicle. So after some trial and error and sorting through some variables, I came up with my shot setups. I decided to get two different shots here. Both setups will be how to shoot in a car without overexposing the sky. For the passenger, I got my framing for the shot. I had my tripod on the front seat with some sandbags locking it down. I knew I wanted to show the window. I then exposed to the sky so that it was not being blown out. Because the main source of light on the subject's face is coming from the window side, that's where the light needs to be placed. I had the subject pin the light between his knee and the ceiling. To power the light, I'll throw on a V-mount battery. The light is set to 5600 Kelvin to match the sun and 100% intensity. Here are my camera settings for the shot.
Now for the driver. If my goal was to have the scene while the car was parked, I could easily place the A100B behind the steering wheel lighting the subject. But since my goal is to show a driving scene, I needed to think differently.
I couldn't safely light the driver without blocking too much of the road.
I decided to change my original plan for the shot and show a silhouette of the driver.
Here are my camera settings for it. Real quick. Safety should be your number one priority. Here are two important rules. Number one, if your actor is actually driving the vehicle, they should only focus on driving. That means no lines and no actions. Number two, their view should not be obstructed by any equipment.
As said before, with no budget, driving car shots are tricky. You'll have to make some sacrifices like camera framing and lighting placement unless you're willing to spend some money. Now let's see the final shot.
Just taking a look at this shot while it's in DaVinci, I would definitely next time want to get rid of the shadow above my head. I think that really takes away the realism of the lighting and it almost makes this shot look super fake. This was definitely a good learning experience. One note I had after filming everything was that if you can't light a scene or the scene doesn't allow you to make a silhouette of the subject, having the scene is probably better than not having the scene altogether. But don't let this discourage you from shooting something in the car if you have to overexpose the sky. It's okay. Using different types of lighting equipment for different circumstances can allow you to achieve certain shots a lot easier.
Comment below any questions you might have, or even what lighting breakdowns you'd like to see in the future. Movies, TV shows, commercials, let me know. Thank you for sticking around and watching another video. These have been a great creative outlet for me, and it's crazy to think that there are actually some people out there that are enjoying the content. It means a lot. See you, friends.